All right. So we see
Hey.
both players have
Very,
three, it
very
looks like.
similar spawns, like they are not in the same
Nearly
places, but
identical.
like within their capital borders, the resources are actually identical.
He is in East based on
One
ruins.
literally 3 seconds into the game screen. Chill, man. All right, so we're clearly not going to see them restart because we've already established that there isn't even amount of trees. We see that Alpha is going
Good.
for the traditional Illyrian opening of putting a warrior on top of an
Boosting.
animal and pushing it.
Want to be rewarded with a
Oh,
nice
he goes
village.
the
Hoping for a
That's where the
back city.
resources are. The safe
But yeah,
resources, I should say.
it is safer.
Particularly because
He
if he
didn't
went,
have any other boost. He had no other boost either.
if he moved a warrior to the center and ran into two Politars,
It's
that would
just dead.
be really unfortunate.
That was a good move. Yep.
Yeah,
Yeah,
I
there's still
absolutely
some
support that.
nice
He's gonna
sanctuary
go
action there
straight
with the
to the
trees that are
center.
like double lined up in the villages.
Well, he doesn't. Unless he meets Scree, he doesn't get the forestry. Or if he has to
Yeah.
pause, but he has to pause one.
He's deciding
Oh,
here.
like
He has some good forests, though.
a wonderful forests.
And then even looking better up to the if it goes up to the north where another village might be.
Is the usual Illyrian strat for Tiny was aggressive, just training as many Politars as he
Yeah,
possibly
that's
could
what
and
he's
hoping they
thinking.
work.
He just hovered the other Politar.
Yeah, but he's thinking because he is also seeing those trees, and he doesn't want to sacrifice his ego too much. I'm thinking, but I found often that being aggressive with Illyrian pays off the most.
This tiny map, there's only a couple villages, so winning a
This is very
village
true.
is, yeah, you get winning a village gets you more Politars.
This is very true. Well, I mean, in this case, he gets one more Politar, but
Yeah,
more centrally
you get a
located Politar.
village and then four
He
Politars, and
did
then you
opt to go
steal
for the
your opponent's
Politar.
village.
All
Doesn't
right,
really
Scriba
matter
is
how much.
climbing.
He goes climbing.
He gets climbing and goes
Yeah.
for the ruin. I think he's hoping for an early boost here.
Yeah, he's. I mean, I think it's a strong play
Could he
because
get
of
Gnarl
how
and
barren
go
that
for like
landscape
Tyrant
is.
Clan?
Yeah, especially
What
since he's already established that Alpha's in the east, and so he knows
if
that he has a 0% chance of losing this village that he
he.
sees.
He can't chop this game though, so it's gonna be a little bit less of a 90 game. Almost
Yeah.
guaranteed. Guaranteed.
I mean, we didn't
Not
think he was going to
guaranteed.
go for knights in the first
Oh.
game, and then he
So we
did.
see Alpha steps off the village in order to put his Politar on it.
But he
Still
still
doesn't
can't
have
afford
the
forestry.
resources for
He still
forestry.
can't
Maybe go
afford.
for like four.
Unless he's going to delay one more turn, but I don't think that
He
would really
could be
I think he
going for
has
the
good
north and
reasons for
south village.
Kree's going for Shiv. Based on, you know, his kind of spastic action over there. Just
Oh,
spamming
he got a
chivalry to
swordsman
attack
for the ruin, and he's skipping the village.
in order to get the stars from meeting Alpha.
He's gambling and it is not paying off.
Mean, all it gives him is another Politar.
I mean, to be fair, in Scree's position, he can absolutely afford to gamble because he only needs one more win
Very
in order to
true,
move
very
on the
true.
trophy. So, if there's anybody in a position to play risky right now, it's Scree.
This is the game to do it, yeah, this exact one. Oh, Alpha goes aggressive up. There's
And
gotta
he
be a
can
village in
afford
the
to.
south.
He
There's
can
a village in the
afford to be
south.
alive. Yes, there is a village to the south. Alpha can get forestry before capturing the city.
Looking pretty strong for Alpha right now.
Yeah,
The
honestly, because he's
veteran
got very
swordsman
little
is
gear.
gonna have to come and do some work, but I guess
Yeah, it really
Politoring
is gonna be
veteran
that heavy
swordsman
lifting.
isn't the best.
He did opt for forestry. And because he ran into Scree's Politar, he knows exactly where he is, and sort of has an idea in his head of what the rest of the map looks like.
Oh, he doesn't find the village there, but he will find it next turn.
Yes, he absolutely will. It's gonna be right next to that ruin up there, I bet.
Let's see what will Scree do? He's gonna be 2, 3 turns behind capturing a first village, and he's gonna have to fight for the second village.
Yeah, this is going to be a very much uphill battle for our dear friend Scree here.
I
He
mean,
opts to kill that
he's
warrior.
got to be kind of torn, right? Just
I
between
think
what
he
he
is.
wants to do with that swordsman, if he wants to use it aggressively, or if he's going to take the turn earlier on getting that village.
He finds the village, but while he's not going to be able to win it.
No, that he is not. Politar kills warrior. Politar kills Politar. This is why I love Illyrian. Boom, boom, boom.
And there's this, the Illyrian was Illyrian like a media map or something. There's always this moment in the center where you meet like two or three villages all clashed together. There's just 2 to 3 turns of everybody's fighting all their Politars in those central like villages.
Politar massacre, I love yes. it.
And just all kill each other real quick, and then you go and you go do riders and stuff.
Oh, it happens every time, and I love it. Oh, Scree is saying, lack of Eastern units plus Eastern cat plus score means he has some poly in the Northeast.
True. Yep.
That he does. Boom. Quick mess.
It is not going to help you to know that, though, since there isn't a lot of ways that you can play around that.
Will it help him enough to win the game is a better question. And how many timed out games does Scree have? Is he just holding all of the season games on his on him?
Probably. I mean, I can't speak for the the planning over there at Crawfish, but I'd have the Scree take all the pro games. I'd have him pull an Arthur.
If only we had someone who knew about the inner workings on Craw. Unfortunately, we don't.
It's quite a shame. Is he going on the village, or he's going to get behind it?
I mean, if he steps on it or doesn't, the elf still has an opportunity to step on it his next turn.
Yeah. I think this is going to be like maybe the third or fourth bold move Scree is going to make this game that doesn't pay off if he decides to step on the village.
Probably better to have a unit in the north than have a dead unit.
It's just dead, yeah.
The elf is going to get the village either way.
He did say he knows there's a Politar up there.
He knows there's a warrior, too.
Yeah,
he's tapping around there. I think he knows that there's stuff in that general area, which he's absolutely right. It's over there.
Scary. This fog is scary.
And now we play the game of how many Politars are in the fog. The most fun game to play when you're playing against Illyrian.
Right, he also a safe move.
Plays it safe.
Which is probably the correct move.
I think he's realizing his boldness was not quite paying off so far this game. Now Alpha wants to think if he wants to hit this warrior here.
I don't think he should, but...
He opts for it.
He does. He goes for the trade, but he still wins the village of the Politars. That's fine.
Yeah, he still has the village unlocked down here.
He's going to keep the village, he's just going to delay it by a turn.
Yeah.
Which is big, but it might not be big
he's
enough.
He's playing it safe because he doesn't know if Scree, for whatever reason, might have a Politar up in that part of the map.
Because Scree does have the one Politar in his cap he never activated. Or enchanted. He never enchanted it.
Enchanted. Yeah, but I think that probably was the... Alpha, they're going for the safer move, trying to think if there would be a Politar up there.
Well, if there would be a Politar, and the Politar killed his warrior, then he couldn't do anything. He actually couldn't win the village.
Valid point. I stand corrected. Now, it is worth pointing out...
Not moving up. He's about to end without moving his poly up.
Now let's just take a moment to point out that Scree is at 2 stars a turn, and Alpha is at 7. So. Yep.
So Alpha knows exactly Scree's vision too. He opted to keep his Politar in place because he knew it was right outside Scree's vision. He didn't want to show him just yet.
I mean, again, Scree did say that he knows there is a Politar in that general direction.
Yeah.
Very true, very true. He gets a sanctuary. It's going to be sanctuary versus hut.
Very true. And right now, actually, that did bring him up fairly evenly to Alpha Zico right there. 6 versus 7.
He's going to be stuck on these 2 villages, though, which is going to be a rough fight.
Very, very rough fight. And not to mention that village. I'm already seeing
three
two Politars.
It's hard to see because this Kree is very spastic. But
Politars. He can so Alpha is going to have access to three more Politars next turn.
Yep.
And not to mention three Politars in very, very close proximity to Scree's capital.
Where's the sword? I can't even see it. Oh my god.
It's on his
it's still on the village, right? It just captured.
Yeah, yeah. Now, Scree does have two Politars he can get on that second village, but one of them would hurt his sanctuary that he just placed.
Yep.
It's going to be a tough decision.
Very, very tough decision, yes.
I mean, the hard thing about this game is we're just looking at it. Scree's behind on villages, on units, on map control, on techs. There's no substantial way that he's ahead of the Alpha. But also, the Alpha
he has a tech on him. Enough stuff. He's got climbing.
You're right.
Mondi's going to be the game
changer.
He has mountain defense. He has
whoever wins, the game is going to take a long time to get anywhere.
He kills a Polly? Is that, did he just kill a Polly? Did he just get a level high number on Politar?
He wants to start.
I think he did.
Is that sacrilegious?
I think so, but he also burned a forest in one of his Polly Live games as LE when that was still a thing, so I don't think Scree's all too worried about that.
I feel like it's worse than Burned Forest. But the developers of the game are only worried about Burned Forest, but not Burned Politar.
Look,
I think they care about the forest,
not
the animals.
All I'm saying is, I read Harry Potter. I know that like the only sin in that world is if you kill a unicorn. So Scree Elder is a sinner. Let's get that in chat. Okay.
Is he gonna go for the double poly pop? That's what they call it. Double poly pop.
Double poly pop.
Yeah.
He very well could.
Rolls off the tongue.
Double poly pop.
Mm-hmm.
Does roll off the tongue.
Speaking of things that roll right off the tongue, I was requested to say something in announcing. I didn't want to, but I'm going to now.
Oh boy, this is going to be good.
The full title. Icky Super Quickie Mover Kicky Fair Try Picky Time the Ticky RNG Sticky Gives a Hickey Supreme Great Grand Finals Battle Balooza. The Grand Finals, we're watching them right now. That's the full and official title.
Yeah, that really is a rolls off the tongue right there.
Yeah, I had to practice that.
In front of you? Did you have it written on the screen in front of you, or...
I did. I was reading.
That is, I don't think I want to be able to. I couldn't do that without reading it.
Even if I was reading it, I don't think I'd be able to do that.
Unique New York. Unique New York.
Peter Piper pecked a pack of pickled peppers. That's one. All right.
He's gonna move this warrior. I'm sure he's thinking about it though. Okay.
Got that 1 HP warrior. He wants to make sure he gets his value out of that thing. he's hovering over chivalry. Scream, no!
He wants it. He wants it so bad, but he can't have it.
I know he wants it, but you can't always get what you want. I learned that from the Beatles, man.
Always get what you want.
What you need is, I don't know, maybe like... just something
can
like...
Can you end up bottom village?
Bonus, get some riders, get some eco... do something.
No, he doesn't win the final village.
Get some math. Get some dragon egg. I'm really not seeing anything.
Alright.
This now is going to be...
If Alpha has roads, he would be able to... Oh, no, he wouldn't. He would get zone of control. Never mind. Don't listen to me. I was about to say he could slide that rider into the cab.
Everybody, don't listen to,
Don't listen to Monlet. I am
Monlet, sorry.
Wait a second. No, he could totally slide his rider up here.
He could.
Let's see what this road gives. If he gets roads here, and that just ends the game.
He can
end the game. He can end my misery.
Does he see the roads?
Why is this your misery? Are you not an impartial commentator?
Well, I don't want him to get 3-0'd, buddy.
It's just that I'm looking at this game, right, and, like, they're, like, taking so long to move through it, And I'm like, I get it. I understand you want to take your time.
He can still do it. 8 plus. Wait, no, 10 plus. Oh, he did the roads.
Yeah,
he had the stars for it. But I guess he's thinking that maybe. Oh, Scree could have unsieged. It would have cost him 2 stars per turn from his sanctuary there, but. No, 4 stars.
Oh, he couldn't
unsieged. She needs the roads.
He has the warrior in range.
He's got the other warrior that he can poly push.
Oh, yeah.
Nice. Okay.
That would cost him 4 stars a turn, though, wouldn't it, from the sanctuaries?
Do you have 2? Yeah, he does. I mean, he would have had to. It would have been his only choice.
Yeah.
He does have quite a little polymania going on.
But my thing means I think this is still, like, pretty safely in the Alpha's hands.
No, absolutely. This is just quite frankly, I think it's just a matter of...
Well, safer for him to go this kind of thing.
I don't like talking about the game like it's a foregone conclusion, and there's still, like, you know, plays for them to make. But also, at the same time...
Archers, here's a play.
I'm just waiting for it to end.
It's archers. Uh-oh.
He did grab archers, so he does have forest defense. Now,
he's got 2 types of defense.
That would be useful if there were forests on the other side of his capital.
Yes.
It's kind of like that, what am I about to say? Oh, wait, no, that doesn't work. Never mind.
I don't know. Ghostbusters?
I think it's exactly like what you were about to say.
I was trying to make a joke about the Maginot line, but I realized it kind of not really, not really applicable here. Anyhow, as to what you were saying, you know, yes, we don't want to say these games are a foregone conclusion, but this game is pretty much a foregone conclusion. It's a very uphill battle for Scree at this moment. Down on villages, down on eco, down on units, down on polys. I mean, could get.
We did learn from game 1, though. What is it? All you have to do is believe. Right? Is that what we said?
Yeah.
That is what we said, but I think that only goes so far.
Oh!
That sounds about Scree.
I think it's only fair in competitions that if that's a valid way to win, that you should try to use every option you have at your disposal to try to win.
Will Scree go for the massive Politoer promotion next turn? The potential Politoer playoff? Potential Politoer... Power move? Power
Scree sells, she sells. Fuck. I messed up.
Oh gosh. Oh, I'm having too much fun here. Alright. What's he gonna do?
He might have to get rid of some eco here if he wants to protect his capital. I mean, he's got an unseed, and that means dropping a warrior on there.
Pop a Politoer too.
He could just opt to make, like,
he's gonna win the South Village! He's gonna win the South Village!
Yes, he's gonna win the South Village, but he's gonna lose his capital.
Or he's gonna have to divert a lot of units with roads to kill that swordsman. But if he goes full poly to defend a capital, he might be able to take South Village and go 3 villages to 3.
I mean, quite frankly, though, does he really need to care about protecting that South Village? He's already got way more pressure on Scree's cap than he should be.
That's true.
I mean, if Scree can protect his capital here, he's going to be able to even up the village count between the two of them. And the sanctuaries are going to start paying for themselves, maybe.
This is true, but at the same time, is it going to be too little too late?
The Alpha could road stuff to defend the South Village, maybe.
He could. I don't think he really needs the Alpha a whole lot, because he does have loads of pressure on Scree's cap.
He might not need to. No, but it would maybe be the safer move.
He does get population from this ruin, so he does have 5 extra stars to play with right now.
Oh, that's a lot of stars. Stonks.
That's a lot of money.
Will he? I can't even see. What health is his warrior at?
2.
Oh, okay, there we go. Yep.
Now, it is worth pointing out, if he does capture this southern village, he will be able to get to
Pipar. Yeah, is there one north of it?
There's one underneath Scree's sword, so once Scree goes to siege the village, bada bing, bada boom, another Politar, thank you, man.
Yes, and there's one north of it too, yeah.
Oh, I didn't even see that one, yeah, so that's...
You can see it's the ears poking right out there. Yeah. So, we stay corrected, he does not win the village.
No, that village is... Yeah, that,
the village is, yeah. I'm trying to get hype for a moment. You know, we're trying to be strategy into it.
You tried to be impartial and make it seem like that we're not all out here trying to root for Alpha, who is currently down 2 out of 2.
We'll see how he... Is Scree gonna go play? Please don't play another game in the middle of the game, Scree. Sometimes he plays another game in the middle of the game.
I think that's what he's about to do.
He's thinking about it. That's a bot. That's a bot. Throw bots.
Hey, but he needs to get rid of that bot in order to get the end game ELO.
That's so true.
Alright, we see Alpha's over here just cleaning up some of Scree's units around that capital.
We lost this show. We missed this show.
Looking at score, still has 13 stars to play with. He is opting to make these Politars, so that village is not safe for Scree.
That village is safe. Not!
Alright, the thing about the 2-minute turn timer...
That's the first time up for the Alpha.
Oh. Okay. So are we going to tell him? Did he hear?
I don't think he got undeafened.
Wait, I think I forgot to unmute for the 20-second warning. Undeafened him, but I forgot to unmute.
He doesn't need to be unmuted. He doesn't need to be unmuted. No, oh, I mean, yourself.
I didn't unmute.
Oh, yeah, because I didn't hear you. Oh, man.
Yeah.
Alright. Scree does opt to siege that village in the south there. Alpha should be
delaying tactic, yeah. That's a thing, he doesn't even need a rider.
And Alpha got a text from Theo saying something.
Something.
Scree does free up his capital.
You still got a rancher back there. A second one? I can't see. It's kind of hard to see.
He used the archer to help kill the Politar that was sieging. And then spawned another archer. I'm just saying, it is working to a degree. And he's really thinking about opening this game right here.
That's one of the big problems with them being able to play the game like this, that they can make it go on forever.
He's trying to get off of the timeout. Who's Eastbark called it?
Yes, this is true. This is true.
Oh.
Ooh. That hurts the archer.
Oh, I was looking at the other side.
Oh, am I the only one watching the actual game we're supposed to be looking at right now?
Perhaps. I mean, just with it being four villages to two, four cities to two.
Yeah, it's pretty safely done.
Got archers in the house here.
I mean, Scree was able to use, like, archers defensively, like, talking about was the preferred method back in Polylive for dealing with tiny alley stuff, Velo eco, just getting like the forest defense bonus and like using some archers occasionally.
Forest, he might have been fight more for it.
Wait, what?
If he had better forest, like on the other side of his village.
Yeah,
if only.
He would have been able to have a nice little defensive line there. That would have made it Alpha's life a lot harder. I don't think it would have been enough to tip the scales ultimately, but it definitely would have made Alpha have to bleed more for the advance. And it is Scree's turn, and we see him busy here fighting with somebody should tell Scree it's his turn.
he's doing it to himself. He's watching the drama. He's getting sucked in.
Self-sabotage right here.
There's the narrative going on himself. Of the game, and then there's the meta-narrative with timing out. And Scree, he doesn't know which one to pick. They're both so engaging.
Alright, Well, from Scree's vision, we see 1, 2, 3, 4 riders, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 Politars. 6 Politars, my bad.
Stormfist! Go! Pew, pew, pew!
Let's go! Woo! Let's go! Oh, yeah! Killing units, this is... That's action.
Yes, this is the polytopia action we were looking for. I paid my $20, yeah.
$20? I paid $400, what do you mean? I thought this was like premium stuff right here, bro.
I think he likes finite.
Maybe I must have had a discount.
They must You're have, right. Yeah, like a 99% discount.
Maybe they partnered with Amazon.
Maybe. Or maybe they partnered with Polycalc, the generous sponsor of Let me stop.
Let's see what the Alpha Omega does in this situation. He knows that it's only a matter of time. He's not worried about trying to run too fast or go too... He knows he's got a significant advantage.
Yeah.
He's gonna get an egg.
Plays it out.
He can just connect with Rhodes here and Giant, right?
Well, yeah, he's gonna make a Giant.
Egg.
At least Spark of Fortune. And then, I mean, if Spree's game plan depends on, you know, stretching this game out longer and longer and playing defensively, eventually Egg is going to become a dragon.
And we all know what dragons do. They light things on fire.
I mean, big thing is that the Spree's trying to just set up any kind of win condition that he can. Whereas, if it was, like, you know, evening out the village count or, like, pulling ahead on EO of Sanctuaries or something. But those all take time, and this dragon is hurting any kind of win condition that Scree can set up.
20-second warning? 20-second warning?
Let's see. Alright, I think we got him this time.
Go Rhodes.
He's getting a siege. Yeah, he gets a siege, so... Unfortunate.
Alright, so we already do have one egg up. So as Inofunny pointed out, that means Scree does not have time on his side now forever. He can unsiege this rider very, very easily. But, can he continue to do that ad infinitum? I do not think so.
We do not think
so. Especially at less than half the eco that the alpha has. Yeah, he sees the Park of Fortune too. He knows it's there.
Yeah, Egg is out there.
He knows one city it can be on too with his vision, so. Alright, Scree. You got a decision.
Get a power!
Get a power!
Org! Oh yeah, get that level up.
Let's go. Yeah.
Oh, yeah.
Get those 5 stars.
Size per turn, baby. No, not 5 stars. It was level 1.
That's a hold. He's gonna drop that monument there.
So he can't get 5 stars right now.
Oh, that's what you meant. Yeah. Is he putting it on the farm? Why are you putting it on the farm?
Desperately looking around tech tree.
Any one of these techs will have my answer.
I need an answer. Desperately looking for answers.
Bonk.
He's got a defense bonus. He's got a defense bonus.
He does got a defense bonus. Honestly, these sanctuaries were a great idea for Scree because
definitely keeping him in.
These Politars are definitely propping him up. And I love that he just continually.
I mean,
he no longer cares. Yes, I do. I do very distinctly remember. Sure, buddy.
You play quickly until it kind of feels like you might be losing, in which case, no resign. No fear, no hesitation. Play until the end of time.
Like, we're just spamming back and forth, not even in the game. That's rough.
You mean, the real game is all in the timer now.
You can feel those heartfelt emotions.
And he goes for a siege on the southern city.
He goes for a double siege. Wait, so that is another unit?
Scree just said, I'ma build a temple, then resign. Well, good luck building a temple with, like, no guards.
Temple. Yeah.
I'ma build a temple, then resign. Classic. Classic move. Well, let's see. Seven...
Depends on the sieges, and if he has to make any more polytars and loses sanctuary income.
Trying to go out with style.
Like, 3 or 4, I think. No. Pop more than that.
Woo!
There we go. He's... Oh, no! He's gotta get, he's gotta get spirit
temple. He doesn't have free spirit either, yeah.
Yeah, he's got a. So that's gonna be. We're gonna need to get 30 stars.
Yeah. Wait, is it a forest temple only 15?
Is it? I wouldn't know.
We need to know about the forest temple. So
you have to know about these mechanics. These high elo mechanics.
Need, free spirit to get a regular temple, but yeah, forest temples are only 15 stars.
Yeah, forest temple is a little bit cheaper for him than the free spirit.
Okay. Okay. Two stars. In that case, that's 25 stars he needs.
Oh
to
wait. Yep. He's almost there. He can disband too.
He doesn't have free spirit. That's the whole problem, right?
Oh, yeah, he can't disband.
He's continually getting sieged. He's not going to get the money for it.
This is a Pyrotar siege. This is a double siege. This is GG right here.
Yeah. It's. I don't think. I hate to break the dream, but I don't think we're seeing a temple.
I don't mind. I'm okay with that.
Move your egg in aggressively. Yes, west.
Aggressive egg.
Yeah.
No.
Egg. If I don't see an egg siege to finish this game,
or a temple, or both,
I'm going to encourage our generous sponsors to pull out.
Yeah, we can't get an egg siege, actually. It's going to be a baby dragon by the time it reaches there.
How do I leave you?
How do you leave the game?
I'm still in the
call.
Somebody just joined the call and was like, how do I leave? And then left.
The most confused man on the internet. I'm glad he figured out his way, though.
And Scree has resigned.
There we go.
Finally.
Yeah, I mean, the maps were not super even between them. Like, the Alpha's villages.
No, he got that first center village.
Closer to the middle. More handily, like, ally them, give themselves to the kind of aggressive Liram playstyle. But at the same time, let's not forget about the really aggressive plays that Scree made that just didn't pay off at all.
Fortunate. Yes.
Although that's fine with his game plan, like Ronald already pointed out. It was 2-0. He was in a position where he could take that risk. It just didn't pay off. Well played from both sides. We're going to be moving into round 4 now.